We'll call out our prayer to our lay most venerable, our prayer for our retreat and for our time during Christmas, together we wait. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. We pray together. Mother most venerable, we have patiently waited with you during your pregnancy with the Christ child. Together we have waited, anticipating the birth of your Son on our altar and our hearts. Continue to detach us from the visible and help us to fix our gaze on the invisible presence of our God and the whole universe. Begotten by so many non-essential things, help us to realize that everything we want and need is right before us in the Eucharist of the Catholic Mass. And may your Son's love overflow the chalice of our hearts when we receive Holy Communion, that we might magnanimously love others as generously as your Son's sacred heart. And the Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go forth with great joy in your heart to celebrate this feast day Mass. Thanks be to God. Our Lady most admirable, Our Lady perpetual help, the great St. John Neumann.
Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are Son of God and Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are the Word made flesh and splendor of the Father. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you. We glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. Who are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. Honor the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, and the glory of God the Father. My brothers and sisters in Christ, as children of our Blessed Mother, we gather before a miraculous picture to honor her, to pray for all of our needs. Unworthy children that we are, let us first of all ask God's mercy. mercy and pardon. Merciful Father, you sent your divine Son to redeem us by his death and resurrection, to give us new life. By this, make us your children, to love one another in Christ. How many times in the past we have forgotten this sublime dignity. We have sinned against our brothers and sisters. We have offended you. Merciful Father, forgive us. Repenting sincerely of our sins, we ask your mercy. May we always live as your truly devoted children. And our opening prayer. Dear Mother of Perpetual Hope, from the cross Jesus gave to us for our mother, you are the kindest and most loving of all mothers. Look tenderly on us, your children, as we now ask you to help us in all our needs, especially this week. God, who called the Bishop St. John Neumann, renowned for his charity and pastoral service, to shepherd your people in America, grant by his intercession that as we foster the Catholic education of youth and are strengthened by the witness of brotherly love, we may constantly increase the family of your Catholic Church. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever. Reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, ever seen God. Yet if we love one another, God remains in us, and his love is brought to perfection in us. This is how we know that we remain in him, and he in us. That he has given us his Spirit. Moreover, we have seen and testified that the Father sent his Son as Savior of the world. Whoever acknowledges that Jesus is the Son of God, God remains in him, and he in God. We have come to know and to believe in the love God has for us. God is love. And whoever remains in love remains in God, and God in him. In this is love brought to perfection among us, that we have confidence on the day of judgment, because as he is, so are we in this world. There is no fear in love, but perfect love drives out fear, because fear has to do with punishment. So one who fears is not yet perfect in love. The word of the Lord. Lord, every nation on earth will adore you. Lord, every nation on earth will adore you. O God, with your judgment endow the king, and with your justice the king's son. He shall govern your people with justice, and your afflicted ones with judgment. Lord, every nation on earth will adore you. The kings of Tarshish, the isles shall offer gifts. The kings of Arabia and Saba shall bring tribute. Lord, every nation on earth will adore you. For he shall rescue the poor when he cries out, and the afflicted one when he has no one to help him. He shall have pity for the lowly and the poor. The lives of the poor he shall save. Lord, every nation on earth will adore you.
Got into the boat with them, and the wind died down.
They were completely astounded. They had not understood the incident of the loaves. On the contrary, their hearts were hardened. The Gospel of the Lord. There once was a game show on TV, back when TV was just black and white. It was called, I've Got a Secret. A contestant would whisper his secret into the show's host, his ear. And then a group of panelists would ask a series of questions and try to guess what the secret was. Today's the feast day the Bohemian-born saint, St. John Neumann, born in 1811. When it came time for John to be ordained, his bishop announced that he wasn't going to ordain any more priests. Bohemia had too many priests already, and the same was true throughout all the countries of Europe. Imagine that. The problem of having too many priests in your country, that the bishop stopped ordaining men. So John wrote to the bishop in America, where the bishop of New York agreed to ordain Neumann. And so in 1835, John left his home forever, traveled across the ocean to a new and rugged land called America. And he took with him a sacramentum, a small chain of beads called the Chaplet of the Infant Jesus of Prague. Now we in Sublette were very familiar with the boy Jesus Chaplet. We know that long before the 30-year-old Jesus went up the hill in Galilee to spend the night in prayer, to decide with his dad who his 12 disciples would be, we know that the boy Jesus had been praying for his 12 best friends ever since the Lord returned from Jerusalem, that time he was lost and they found him in the temple when he was 12 years old. How our Lord had held on to the secret of who his 12 best friends would be. He held on to that secret for 18 years. Not even Mary or St. Joseph knew who the 12 were. The second person of the Trinity prayed for those 12 every day for 18 years, and then for 3 more years after he called them to be disciples. St. John Neumann took this Bohemian sacramental with him to America, and it's a secret to this day, never been revealed. Bishop prayed for his 12 best friends, whom he prayed for every day until his death in 1860. Each of us has a secret as well, don't we? Each of us who has adopted this Bohemian sacramental also prays for our 12 closest friends. We pray one Hail Mary for them every day, and we ask the 12 best friends of our Lord, the apostles, to also pray a Hail Mary for our 12 loved ones. Of course, it's not hard to guess who we pray the 3 Our Fathers on the chaplet for. We pray to the Holy Family of Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, for ourselves, and for our mom and our dad. But the secret of who the 12 are, since few of us have 12 brothers and sisters, that secret, whispered into the ear of Jesus Christ, is not known by anyone else but our Lord. Each one of the 12 holy apostles knows one of your 12 best friends. But only our Lord knows the secret of all 12 names. On the TV show, I've Got a Secret, the panelists, they seldom guess the secret. Seldom. But that was really the fun of the show. Secrets are meant to be kept here on Earth. But remember our Lord said how at the end of time, what is whispered in secret will be shouted from the rooftops in heaven. Remember? Can you imagine when Jesus Christ makes known to all heaven the 12 persons you prayed every day on earth for? That's just yet another one of the joys of heaven. When the world and all the angels find out who you prayed the infant Jesus of Prague, Chaplet for. Merry Christmas. St. John Neumann, Our Lady Perpetual, Our Lady Most Admirable. We petition our Mother perpetual help. Holy Mary, Holy Virgin conceived without sin, our Mother perpetual help. We sinners call to you that we may give our hearts completely to Christ this Christmas season, that we may be filled with the Holy Spirit and become courageous witnesses of Christ's love for men, that we may be more and more like our divine Lord as you were, that we may be meek and humble of heart like your Son, Jesus. That we may fear losing God's friendship forever by our unrepented sins. That we may seek Christ's mercy and forgiveness constantly in the sacrament of penance. That we may be aware of God speaking to us in the events of daily life. That we may pray daily with love and trust, especially in moments of temptation. That we may realize the value of worshiping God together in the Eucharist. That we may grow in love of Christ and our neighbor by our frequent communion. That we may reverence our bodies as temples of the Holy Spirit. That we may strive to be true Catholics by our loving concern for others. That we may proclaim the dignity of work by doing our own work conscientiously. That we may forgive from our heart those who have wronged us. That we may see the evil of seeking our own interests at the expense of others. That we may work for the just distribution of this world's goods. That we may share our talents with others for the good of the community. That we may accept our responsibility in the community in a spirit of genuine service. To pray that the Holy Spirit may guide and strengthen Pope Francis, the bishops, and the clergy. That we may be blessed with an increase of priestly and religious vocations. That we may bring the knowledge and love of Christ to those who do not know him. That we may be aware of our dependence on God, even in the midst of our human achievements. That we may be ready at death to enter the home of our Heavenly Father. That we may die at peace with Christ and our fellow men. That we may be comforted at the death of our dear ones by our hope in the risen Lord. Pray that our departed brothers and sisters quickly share in your Son's resurrection. We pray in a special way for the intention of this Mass, the repose of the soul of June Stefanich. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord. Perpetual light shine upon her. May she rest in peace. May June's soul and all the souls of the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. We had our own intentions in the silence of our hearts.
We call out to Our Lady asking for intercession and for the perseverance of St. John Neumann, that if we adopt the sacramental of the Infant Jesus of Prague Chaplet, that we would persevere in praying for our 12 best friends, the people we long to see in heaven. So we call out, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Holy Mary, help us in our needs. Pray for all the people of God. May all experience your perpetual help.
Lord, you gave us Mary to be our mother, ever ready to help us. Grant us the grace to bring forth to her in all our needs. Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth, the work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual bread. Pray, my brothers and sisters in Christ, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. The Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and of all his holy church. Merciful Father, look upon the gifts we have placed on your altar, and grant that we may reflect the image of Christ your Son, just as you granted to St. John Newman to imitate what he celebrated through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and true God, through Christ our Lord. For on the feast of this awesome mystery, though invisible in our own, in his own divine nature, he has appeared visibly in our nature. Begotten before all ages, he has begun to exist in time, so that raising up in himself all that was cast down, he might restore unity to all creation and call straying humanity back to the heavenly kingdom. And so with the angels and all the saints, we praise you as in joyful celebration we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and blemished. sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your Holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to bar our uniting governor throughout the whole world, together with our servant Francis and the Pope and David our bishop, and all those who hold you to the truth and on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember your servants, especially Jerry and Patricia Garland, all the members of our late Perpetual Help Church. And all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you, for them we offer you the sacrifice of praise, or the offer for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glories of the Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, and all your saints, we ask that through their merits and prayers in all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation, counted among the flock of those who have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord, Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands. With eyes raised to heaven, to God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands. Once more giving him thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, keep this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and the eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, Lord, until you come again. Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer we ask, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us, through this participation at the altar, receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants, especially Jude Stefanich, all of our deceased parents, any of our 12 best friends who are deceased. They have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep. Grant them, Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, to their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, the glory, and the mercy, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Everyone who has given up home, brothers or sisters, father or mother, wife or children, or property for my sake, will receive many times as much and inherit everlasting life. Now, a prayer scripture for you, especially for those 12 persons on our Images of Prague Chaplet needs. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Blessed Sacrament. Love you above all things, and desire you myself. Since other people dear to me cannot now receive you sacramentally, I ask you to come at least spiritually into their hearts. As though you are already in our hearts, help us to embrace you and unite ourselves wholly to you. Permit not we should ever be separated from you. You have come to me, I am one with you. I want you to remain with me forever, this life and in the next.
Thank you for allowing me to share your divine life. May I become more like you through this sacred food. Let me never take you for granted, but always pray for those whose lives are dark with sin and ignorance and selfishness. Let me remember the words of St. Paul, that there before the grace of God go I. Each day I become more like you, O Lord, and each day I can pray for those who have never heard of your presence in the universe, or who have heard it and rejected it.
We'll pray for a consecration to Mary. Immaculate Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and Mother of the Church, you're also Mother of Perpetual Help. With hearts full of love for you, we consecrate ourselves to your Immaculate Heart, so that we may be your devoted children, obtain for us true sorrow for our sins, and fidelity to the promises of our baptism. We consecrate our minds and hearts to you, that we may always do the will of our Heavenly Father. Consecrate our lives to you, that we may love God better, and live not for ourselves, but for Christ, your Son, that we may see him and serve him and others. By this humble act of consecration, your Mother of Perpetual Help, we pledge to model our lives on you, the perfect Christian, so that consecrated human life and death, we may belong to your divine Son in all eternity. Prepare this day. Lord Jesus Christ, truly present in the most blessed Eucharist, we adore you. It has pleased the Father, and in you all his fullness and love, and that through you he should reconcile all things to himself. Grant us the grace to be truly grateful for all that our Father has done for us. Grant that we may be truly sorry for our sins and do penance for them. Through you we thank the eternal Father for the gift of life. He has created all wonderful things of this world. May we learn to use them well, so that through them we may grow in love for him. Above all, we thank our Father for sending you to us as the greatest expression of his love, to save us and all creation by your death and resurrection. We thank you, Lord, for giving us your own mother to be our mother and perpetual help. May the countless favors we have received through her intercession, and especially through this novena, inspire us with greater confidence in God's love and mercy. And her perpetual hope. Grant that we may always do the holy will of God. Perseverance in love, to the most holy Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, the honor, the glory, and thanksgiving, ever and ever. We pray for the sick, especially of our parishes and our own families. Lord Jesus Christ, you bore our sufferings and carried our sorrows in order to show us clearly the value of human weakness. Graciously hear our prayers for the sick. Grant that those who are weighed down with pain and other afflictions and illness may realize that they are among the chosen ones, whom you call blessed. Help them to understand that they are united with you and your sufferings for the salvation of the world. We pray our prayers to Joseph for happy death. Blessed Joseph, who died in the arms of Jesus and Mary, obtain for me, I beseech you, the grace of a happy death, and that hour of dread and anguish, assist me by your presence and protect me by your power against the enemies of my salvation. Into your sacred hands, living and dying, Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, I commend my soul. Amen. And let us pray. Refreshed by our participation in the memorial of the death and the resurrection of your Son, we ask, O Lord, that by the example of St. John Newman, we may experience the power of this sacrament and remain constantly in the Catholic Church by the bond of unity and truth. Through Christ our Lord. So, could you wish you a Merry Christmas, and on the Feast of the Holy Family, when we had the blessing of the Infant Jesus Prague Chaplet, so I had to go right away to West Brooklyn's church. So I just processed them right out the back door, so you didn't get a chance. If you'd like to get a chaplet for yourselves or another person, just come up after Mass. They've already been blessed. Okay. The Lord be with you. Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing on this feast of St. John Newman. day between Epiphany and baptism. May God, who has called you out of the darkness into his wonderful light, pour out in his kindness his blessings upon you and those for whom you pray, that your hearts may be firm in faith, hope, and charity. Amen. And since in all confidence you follow Jesus Christ, who today appeared in the world as a light shining in the darkness, may God make you also a light for your brothers and sisters. Amen. And so when your pilgrimage is ended, may you come to him whom the Magi sought as they followed the star, and whom they found with great joy, the light from light, who is Christ the Lord. Amen. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life. St. Michael, Archangel, Prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.